Running in, this is a brisk 72 minutes, and from 1917 comes John Ford's directorial debut. And it's strange and a very weird first for me because it's a Western movie, which I'm rather fond of from the 50s up to the late 70s. I kind of love Westerns. And this has a lot of the kind of tropes that we're going to discover in later years. It feels like a kind of precursor to most of those, and you definitely feel like this is a John Ford movie. It has a lot of his staples throughout it. Now, the basic story here is about cattlemen versus the settlers, and their kind of battle for land and the freedom of that. And we have a cattleman who hires some hired hands to go and take out the settlers so that he can drive the cattle through, beat all these fenced off areas. And it's a basic kind of premise, but so much comes from it, and there's some wonderful great ideas that Ford really does. Now, this camera has lots of kind of edits. Now, I've seen a lot of silent movies so far, but this really feels as if it briskly moves thanks to the editing, and has some really stark composition shots within it, and strange uses of the camera where it almost blacks out everything else to focus on one face before fading in to the rest of the scene. There is lots of various characters all talking, and the intertitles all display the name of the character that's saying the words, because we may never go back to that character again at certain points. There are certain moments that are just downright hilarious when two of the hired hands meet each other in a bar and they start to size each other up, looking at each other as if, who's the better gunslinger here, before the two of them decide to get absolutely hammered at the bar, downing whiskey shots like it was water. And just to see these two guys almost acting kind of drunk later on was really just kind of fun to watch happen. I really enjoyed that sequence. And it kind of tails off with a little bit of stunt work as well. There's a moment where two of the characters jump out of a top window onto a horse and kind of ride away. It's driving rain. The two gunslingers jump out the window and fire off several shots into the distance. There's a moment later on with some other stunt work where someone's riding a horse down into a river to cross it and comes off in the water. And it never cuts, it just kind of holds that shot as the rider tries to get the horse up, tries to get back on it and out of this water as quickly as they can. There is a huge gunfight at the end of this one as the settlers hold up waiting on their attackers to come. It's a little bit tense. You kind of know where the outcome is going to go in this one, but it doesn't really matter. And there is one hell of a montage shot in here as well, which I always appreciate. I really love the look of the movie and how they use the 4x3 scope to really show the rolling hills, the cattle, the large areas that they have. When the horses and the riders are traversing the landscape, it really shows you from a distance how kind of treacherous the terrain can be at times as well. And I really do like Harry Carey as the main performer, the kind of bad guy who suddenly has a heart of gold and decides to help rather than hinder the settlers. I really kind of liked his performance, including his wonderful introduction to the film as well. It was great fun. I'd love to know your thoughts on Straight Shooting if you've seen it. Let me know in the comment box below, and I'll see you next time on Man V Film.